Welcome to the Vector Garden. In this quick tip, we're going to talk about stroke width. I've got two lines here and both have strokes applied. And let's take a look at the stroke panel and check them out. So we've got a 1 point stroke on the bottom, and at the top, we've also got a 1 point stroke. And Illustrator does not lie. This is 1 point stroke width and the other one as well. So why is that top one thicker than the bottom one? And I have deliberately hidden the control panel here because in the control panel, this would be obvious. It also can be seen in the properties panel, but it's not so obvious. So let's turn on the control panel here and then you see right into your face, 5 point round. 5 point round is a brush. So here we've got the brushes panel and then there is 5 point round applied. This can happen when you use the brush tool to draw something, then Illustrator will always automatically apply a brush to it. The brush tool cannot work without applying a brush. And usually that is a calligraphic brush. And those, especially those even ones, get applied by default because Illustrator starts at the very top of that panel to apply a brush. And then we get this one. And you often cannot tell that one apart from a default stroke because it has an even stroke width along that path. So how does the stroke weight come into play with brushes? Let's take a look at that brush. So here I've got the brushes panel and let's just double click it. And there you see its name is 5 point round. It's default and it has its own size, which is 5 point. So that's the stroke weight it produces. And the stroke width that you apply in the stroke panel kind of multiplies that. So if we apply 2 point, then it's multiplied by 2. So actually it's a 10 point stroke. We can just make a comparison. If I take this one and apply a 10 point stroke to it, then you see that matches. And if you apply a 0.5 stroke to it, then we get half of that 5 point. So that's how the stroke weight interacts with brushes as a multiplier. And that's why we get this result. And also, if you do not want to have a brush on your path, then use the pencil tool to draw it. It acts the same, it only does not use a brush, and then you do not have to get rid of that brush. If you have that brush applied, then go into the brushes panel and apply that basic, and basic is not a brush, it deletes the brush from that path, and then you have just a normal stroke applied to your path, and you can just apply the stroke weight, which then acts pretty normal as expected.